Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. So for today's video, I came up with this gold and teal green eyeshadow look. So if you are interested to know how I created this, then please continue watching. For eyebrows, I'm using this Anastasia's brow piece, and it is a brow gel and it will give you that similar soap brow effect, but you don't need water or setting spray to activate. You just have to take it on a spoolie and rub it on the back of the cap, and in this way you can activate it and use it directly on your brows. The brush I'm using is the Anastasia's number 12 brush, I think. A very hassle-free product, unlike the soap brow thing, because the soapy thing, they make your eyebrows very stiff and difficult to work with, and later up when you start sweating, it starts little bit lathering up. That's why I don't like the soap brow, and this one is just perfect if you are not used to any other techniques of the brows. If you want, you can use any brow powder, but don't use pomade or any other waxy stuff, because they will slip and slide and won't stay that long. For brow powder, I'm using this NYX Eyebrow Cake in black gray. The only powder I love, because the shade is absolutely perfect. It's a cool tone color. So if you have any gray or taupey sort of eyeshadow, you can use that to fill in your brows if you have the dark brows. I don't like to use brown because it looks kind of fake and not good. I'm using angle side to fill in the product, and then you have to brush through to blend it. Now starting with the eyeshadows, I'm using this Age Rewind Concealer from Maybelline and using this as my eyeshadow base. This is in the shade Ivory, and I think the second lightest or the lightest shade, I don't know. So if you are using any concealer as an eyeshadow base, make sure you are using 2 to 3 shades lighter, and the concealer should be matte and it should have full coverage, because whatever eyeshadow you're gonna be applying it on it next should stick and pop more. That's why. And you can see how easily it blends on the lid, and it stays very much intact until you take this off. So a very 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 good product to use as an eyeshadow base. Thank you. Now I'm going with the previous brush to blend my second shade. In this way, the blend is more seamless. Now I'm taking this third shade, which is Hunt's. It is a burnt orange shade to add on the 2/3 of my lid. And the brush is from Morphe, it's I think M506. For colorful shadows, you have to pack more and blend less. In that way, they show up very nicely. If you just go adding shades and blend it more and more, it won't show up that nicely. So you have to pack more and blend less. But every step you have to repeat at least twice or thrice to get the maximum intensity. Now I'm going with the second brush to blend my third shade. And I'm blending both the shades Puky and Hunt. Now I'm adding this shade Jax in the outer corner, in just the outer V, because I have hooded eyes, so I'm not taking this darker shade all the way in. I'm just adding this to the outer corner to add some definition to the look. And again, I'm using the same brush, that's Morphe M506. I use that same brush both for my crease and for my outer V. Now I'm just cleaning the same brush on a tissue paper to take the excess product out, and I'm blending the shade Jax and Hunt's together. Now we have to cut the crease, so I'm taking the same Maybelline Age Rewind concealer on back of my hand, and I'm coating any sort of concealer brush that is stiff, and you have to coat the brush from both the sides nicely with this concealer. And if you have very defined crease, you can directly cut the crease, but I don't have defined crease, I have hooded eyes. So what I do is I do stamping motion, and in this method you don't have to close your eyes completely, keep it open, and you can see my crease where the fold of the skin is, and just slightly above that I'm marking my crease. You can just take your time with this process. Now I'm patting that part with my fingers so that there is no patchiness, and the blend should appear smooth when I apply my next matte shade. In this way you can take the excess concealer off your lid. Now I'm taking this liquid eyeshadow from Swiss Beauty, and this does not stay that long on the lid, so you have to use any sort of glitter adhesive. So I'm using one from the pack, and first you have to apply that glitter adhesive, and then you can go with the liquid glitter, but don't put too much pressure or else it will move the base underneath. Just be gentle with this process. Now again, you have to blend the outer edges with fingers. Here I'm taking this golden shade, the name is Queen, on a very detailed brush, and I'm just adding this to the outer edges of that golden liquid shadow. After you're done applying the shimmer shadow, now you have to finish the blend using all the three matte shades, the first being Puky, the lightest one. Following the shade is Hunt's and then Jax. I'm I'm applying mascara from Too Faced. This is the Damn Girl mascara. Now for primer, I'm using Milani's Prime Perfection. This is a very nice primer. It's very hydrating and very soothing. It has a minty sort of fragrance to it, and it feels like little bit of like fericol texture. I don't know, yeah, but it is really soothing, and it is not a pore blurring primer. It's good for hydration. Although it looks very oily and sticky, but in real it's not that oily. And for foundation, I'm using the L'Oreal's Fresh Wear foundation in the shade Golden Beige and the Maybelline Master Strawberry Cream, and I'm mixing the two and applying it directly on the face. Here I'm using the Morphe sponge to blend the foundation. This is a very skin-like foundation and it has medium to buildable coverage. L'Oreal originally had their matte foundation in the infallible thing, and now they have come out with the Fresh Wear, which is more for dry skin, and it is a very dewy foundation. I really like this one. For concealer, I'm using the Pat Take Cover Concealer in the shade Butterscotch, which is I think one or two shades darker than my skin. It looks fine in the video, but it is actually one or two shades darker, so it's good for hiding any under eye circles or the pigmentation marks. The consistency of this concealer is very nice. It's not overly drying or overly hydrating, so it blends very nicely and sits very nicely on the skin. I love the fact it does not dry out my under eyes, unlike other matte concealer, and it does not even slip and slide like a hydrating concealer. Now here I am adding some other concealer. This is from the Flower Beauty in the shade Light Medium. So this was my exact skin tone shade, and that's why I will be adding some Maybelline Age Rewind concealer in the shade Ivory, and I'm blending it with the help of this packed concealer brush in the number 219. It's a very densely packed brush, just like a beauty blender on a stick. Now for powder, I'm using this packed translucent powder in the shade 10. I'm applying this with the pack puff. I've seen other makeup artists using this technique, and it actually works, because after you are done applying your makeup, your skin looks very smooth, which I like. Here I'm using a cream blush from Hina Ina Beauty in the shade Mellow, and take the blush on the back of your hand, and you can use a very dense brush to apply this product on your cheeks, because if you go directly on your cheeks, the blush is very pigmented and it will be difficult to blend. So take it on the back of your hand, warm it up, and use a brush to apply it. You can use this product on your eyes and lips as well. It's a very multi-tasking product. Now I'm taking the extra bake off using this brush. For contour, I will be using Kiko Milano Bake Powder. This is the compact powder in the number 6. It's not a bronzer. They do have bronzers in the same range. It's a very silky and finely milled compact powder. And for the brush, I'm using this one from ELF. It's the Beautifully Bare Blending Brush, I think. I got this one from Amazon. For highlighter, I'm using the Focalure Sculpin Glow Highlighter in number 03. It's a very smooth and pigmented highlighter. This one is in the shade 03, I think, and I'm applying this with help of a wet and wide brush. For blush, I'm using Lakme 925 in the shade Nude Flush. It's a very affordable blush and I'm surprised by the quality. Look how pigmented it is. For kajal, I'm using this one from Urban Decay. It's the 24/7 Glide-On Liner and applying this just on the outer one fourth of the lash line. I'm packing the shade Enchantress, which is a very deep green shade on that kajal. You have to apply this on just the lower two-thirds of the lash line. Don't go all the way in because we will be applying other shades as well. I'm packing the teal blue shade from the palette. The name is Jada or something on the top of that green shadow to make it look like a teal green shade. Now I'm blending both the shades with the help of the shade Hunt. Now I'm blending even further using the shade Pukey. Taking the shade Pool Party, and I will be applying in the inner one third of my lower lash line. Just to add a pop of color because all the shades are warm neutrals, so this will add a really nice hint of color to the look. Now I'm applying the same highlighter as my inner corner highlight, taking the lip contour kit from the Huda Beauty. This lip liner appeared to be more of a purple or grayish sort of on my lips, and that's why I will be applying some pink lipstick to neutralize it because it was looking very very gray, purple, weird. Now I'm using the same Hinayana blush in the shade Mellow as a lipstick to neutralize my lip color. Topping that off with the Huda Spa Bullet in the shade Pearl Strip. For the final step, I will be packing this black eyeshadow on top of my lash band, so that it can hide the lash band as well as any glue that's been peeking through. I don't generally apply liners because I have hooded eyes and this trick works beautifully. It makes your lash band appear thicker and fuller. So here's the finished look. I hope you guys had fun watching this, and if you did, then please leave a like, subscribe to my channel, and I will see you in my next video. Till then, take care. Bye bye.